Muslim. The fact that they are both Christian is beside the point. Reality doesn't often get in the way on the canvas.
Morcos, who is from North Lebanon and the Muslim end of Lebanon, just put Christian Lebanon flat on his back. And once again...
Anything goes and the spectators really get into it. Groin grabbing's okay. You don't have to stay in the ring. You risk being Irish whipped by the ear. Eye gouging's part of the act. Sometimes boots on the menu. And after the bout, there's no need to be good sports.
Oh, I didn't like any of them.
Do you think it's good for kids to come along?
Yeah, every month.
Why do you barrack for a particular person?
Oh, because of his country.
Wrestling is many things. A battle between countries, between religions, good and bad, for the title belt, or to see two man mountains pit their skills against each other. But stripped of all the symbolism, the bare skills attract only a few.
I like watching them belt their brains out.
Do you think it's fair dinkum?
Nah, it's all crap.
In the USA, WrestleMania attracted a record crowd for an indoor sporting event. 80,000 people crammed in to see their favourites do mock battle. To see the midgets parade, the Hulks prevail. It's a huge business. Glamorous and pretentious, right down to the way the wrestlers are transported to the stage.
As champion Randy Macho Man Savage and his lovely Elizabeth took on arch rival Ricky the Dragon Steamboat with help in the corner from George the Animal Steel.
Here they walk in their own style. This is the light heavyweight Australian title fight. The good guy is Italy's Lou Marcello. The man in black, Sydney's cocky Kenny Medlin, the belt holder. Kenny likes getting those against him fired up. But at the same time, he has a groundswell of support, even a fan club.
Really, there's only one wrestler and it's Kenny Medlin.
Yeah.
The president will...
Yes, he is the best of them all. When Kenny Medlin wrestles, the whole world stops and watches.
Come on, baby. Oh, get in the road. Come on now.
Miraculously, the evil champ got out of a lot of tight situations, and to the disgust of Marcello's fans, the fight went to the cocky one. But for those who like a good guy, the next wrestler out, Corporal Hardy, takes the cake. His evil opponent, Sinister Steve Rackman, acts out the nasty to end all nasties. As in life, the good guys rarely win, coming across as martyrs, with the ref failing to stop the baddies from taking unfair advantage. The luckless corporal was laid out through fair means and foul.
I feel like I've been wrong. I've been hit with a freight train. It's a match like this is one of the most savagest matches ever. If someone gets the upper hand on you, you just can't carry on. Anything can happen in it. That's why the referee is powerless in a match like this. Because when there's $2,000 at stake, it's go for it.
It's Rambo gone over the top with childish symbolism throughout performances that are hard to find credible. If the wrestlers are fair dinkum as they claim, then they overact horribly. But one thing is undeniable. The crowd, or at least this crowd, loves it.
See the way he walks down the street. That's the way he shuffles.
George Barnes is anything but gorgeous, and his mate the Animal is just that. They took on the Golden Greek Billy Condoleon and fellow good guy Kevin Martin for the Australian heavyweight tag team title.
Do you think it's a fair dinkum sport?
Well, there's rumours it's not, but I don't know.
Yeah, we don't believe those. We don't believe those rumours. This is the real wrestling, not like that American stuff you get on the telly.
Look at us! Look at the animal! Look at the gorgeous one! And you only have to look at the physiques, the body, the know-how, the charisma! We've got it all! We've got it all!
We had it all!
This, baby, look at this. Don't go away, honey. I know what you want. You want the animal. What the animal wants you, honey. Don't worry. The animal loves you. I see you right now looking at the animal. The animal been looking at you, honey. Anytime. I don't touch much. Anytime you got the money, honey, you come and see the animal to give you a little surprise.
You're spitting on me.
Do they expect to be taken seriously? That's irrelevant because their following proves that in some strange way, these performers are winners in an activity that teeters on the brink between pure entertainment and sport.
In a way, it's a bit of a sport, and in a way, it's more of a show sort of thing.
Do you think it's any good seeing some of those people be so evil?
Yeah, because then it gives all the crowd something to enjoy.
It's all a load of rubbish, but I reckon it's fun.
I don't believe what this place does to Kieran Pratt. Ted Thomas and the rest of the management committee, you've got to do something.